Hello and welcome to you all, and our today's topic is bacteria sporulation. So at first we have to understand what is called sporulation. Sporulation is the formation of spore. Sporulation is the formation of spore. So at now we have to understand what is called this spore, right? Spore is dormant form of life. Dormant form of life which helps to survive in a critical condition or hostile condition or in harassed condition. Microorganisms to survive in a harassed condition or uncomfortable condition, which is not suitable for that microorganisms or for that cell. Right, so that is called unsuitable condition or unfavorable condition. So spore helps to survive in that particular unfavorable condition. Now, what is called spore? Spore is the dormant form of life. What is dormant form of life? Dormant form of life means in the sleeping condition or in resting condition or in resting state. Okay, in resting state. Okay, so spore is the dormant form of life or sleeping condition or resting condition, resting period of life, which helps to survive in which condition? In unfavorable condition or in a non-suitable condition. Non-suitable condition for that particular microorganisms or for that bacteria. When the bacteria understand or realize that its surrounding condition is not good, is not favorable for that that microorganism, then it can produce or form a spore. So sporulation is the formation of a spore, right? And spore is the dormant or resting period or resting condition of that microorganism, which helps to survive in that unfavorable condition. Okay, now, so sporulation is the formation of spore by that vegetative cell. Why it's called vegetative cell? Because in normal condition, one normal cell, it will, after certain period of time, it will divide from one cell to another cell. Right. So it is called normal cell division. So normally a cell is under the vegetative cell condition, so it can by the help of the binary fusion from one cell it can divide into another two cells, right? And after that it can again and again divide. So division will continue. So this condition of the cell is called vegetative cell. Okay, that vegetative cell can produce spore. Okay, but when that vegetative cell will produce spore, after that that cell will not divide or will not division will stop. Okay, so after that the conversion of spore or the formation of spore, that vegetative cell will transfer in its non-vegetative condition, right? Because after the formation of spore, it will not divide again. Before, when it is under the normal vegetative cell condition, then it can divide. Okay, so what we can understand, sporulation is the formation of spore by that vegetative cell during unfavorable condition, unfavorable condition. Okay, so this is called bacteria sporulation. Sporulation is formation of spore by that vegetative cell. Why it's called vegetative cell? Because in the normal time it can divide from one cell to another two cell, right? One cell to another two cell, and division will continue. So that state is called vegetative cell. So vegetative cell will produce spore when it is under in an unfavorable condition. So I am trying to discuss it with the help of an example. Suppose this is the structure of a bacteria. This part is the chromosomal DNA. Chromosomal DNA. And this is the cell wall. Okay. Now, this bacteria is under its favorable condition or normal condition. It can get its enough or sufficient nutrients from the surroundings. No condition is occur which can hamper its any. Suppose sufficient nutrients is available in its surrounding, and the surrounding atmosphere is suitable for its growth. So what will happen? It will goes under its binary fusion for its division. Within 30 to 60 minutes gap, within 30 to 60 minutes gap, this is the approx 30 to 60 minutes gap, it will go under its division, right? That is by the help of binary fusion. What we can see, a center midpoint, we can see a center midpoint division, right? Center midpoint division. And by the help of the binary fusion from one bacteria cell, it will divide in its two different cell, right? So what will happen when this bacteria is in normal or suitable condition, when it can get its sufficient nutrients from surrounding, the environment is suitable for its growth, then there is no problem at all at the vegetative state. then between the 30 to 60 minutes gap, it can goes under the help of binary fusion, it can divide into from one to two different microorganisms, right? So it is called vegetative cell division or normal cell division. So it's called vegetative cell division. Okay, vegetative cell division. But now when these microorganisms are under its not favorable condition, when what is called unfavorable condition, we have to understand at first. Suppose in this beaker there has nutrients or nutrients in the nutrients media for the growth of these microorganisms. So from this nutrients media it can get its sufficient nutrients for its growth. Okay, but till now it's favorable condition. But if we heat this media, if we give heat in this media, then what happens? Then the temperature of this media will increase. At that time, that condition will be suitable for the survival of this microorganism. Not at all, because the temperature is increasing gradually. So what will happen? At that time, this microorganism has to survive. How it is possible? There are two things. May it will die, it will not fight against that condition, it will die. One condition is it will die. Or another condition is, to survive in this condition, it can produce spore. Okay, it can produce spore. So how it's possible, we will discuss this.